Our mission is three words. It's protect, heal, and care. And I think those are powerful words. And when you think about it, our mission is all about protecting vulnerable individuals who can't protect themselves, helping people who have been harmed some way, psychologically or physically, to heal from the trauma that they have experienced. And we're there to help people who have nobody else to care for them. We used to look at people as being broken. Now we look at people and say, what has happened to you? Let's understand what has happened to you so that we can really focus on understanding that, fixing that, making sure we don't make those same mistakes over and over again. You know, I don't know that there's any really typical client that we serve because we really do cut across all socioeconomic areas. All different types of problems come through our door. So to say that we only deal with the really intense, high-end, serious stuff in the community is not accurate. We do a lot of prevention work. We do a lot of education work in the community. We work with young children. We work with newborns and their families. We work with individuals that are going through marital and family issues, and we work with folks that are just kind of isolated and don't have anybody else in their lives who are struggling just to figure out where they're headed. One of the things that we do at Family Services is we maintain this, what I call a hang in there philosophy, and our ability to give individuals a second chance or a third chance or a fourth chance even as they work their way through their treatment, I think is a really powerful thing that we do. Last year, we served over 1,400 sexual assault victims through our sexual assault center. As we look at sexual assault and the Me Too movement, it's really something that everybody is acutely aware of these days, and I think our numbers reflect that. What we do when somebody is victimized, they are able to reach out to the center and an advocate will jump on that case right away and will be there for emotional support for that individual almost from the time that the episode happens. In addition to that, we're able to stay with these individuals throughout all of the medical and legal proceedings that have to happen as a result of a sexual assault. We've got somebody in their corner supporting them, guiding them, helping them navigate what can be oftentimes a really confusing system. If Family Services just closed up and went away, I think the immediate impact on this community and the obvious impact on this community is that 18,000 individuals who we served this past year would not get the service they need. We would see an increase in homelessness. We would see an increase in crime. We would see an increase in abuse. All of the things that were there trying to derail, we would see those things happen. And we would see the impact kind of then come back to roost in the communities. And I don't think we can ever undersell the need for our communities to be safe. Whether it's safety within a family, it's safety in our schools, it's safety walking downtown Green Bay or downtown Appleton. If we don't have safe communities, we're in a lot of trouble. And anything that we can do to make our communities safer, I think is really kind of that underlying part of our mission. We've had an amazing number of people who have turned their lives around. You know, a number of years ago, you would have seen this person as like, they're a problem in our community, and now they are part of the solution in this community. And that is pretty neat to see that. So we've done a lot of good work for a lot of years, but I think we're at the point now where we have to stay really nimble, really flexible, and we have to be able to adapt. And adapt doesn't just mean bringing in a new program or doing things a little bit differently. It really means being able to shift gears and go in a completely different direction, throw out some of the traditional stuff we've done in the past, and be willing to take some risks and be innovative. If we had the flexibility of another $2 million to really get creative and develop innovative programming, it would be amazing to see what we could do in this community.